Hey everybody, welcome back to some more Pokemon Light Platinum and playthrough. And today we are going to be facing the gym leader, but before we do that, there are some freebies around town that you want to get. The first one is from this person right here. Do you have a Pokemon? Do you have six Pokemon in your party? Yes. Come back to me when you have a free space and I have a gift for you. This is the Eevee Egg, and I do have a full party on my team, which is kind of annoying. So let me just go to Pokemon. And let me just show you my team real quick, because I spent like the last 2 days leveling up, and I have Combustion at 32, which is from, you know, didn't do anything work on it because it was already past the level 30 mark. I then worked on my Bayleaf because I know I'm going to keep that, so it's at level 30. Electric Buzz was the, I forgot the name now, Electric Kid, whatever name thing was. Yeah, so we had that, we evolved it into the Electric Buzz, kept at level 30 because that was the level it evolved at. The Zoroark, we evolved that at level 30, so I pushed it to that level to get it. And War Turtle, I had at level 31. I'll try getting to the 32, but I just couldn't be arsed at the end. So yeah, that's the dream team. We're actually going to get rid of this Pokemon right here because it's not needed. And after knowing that we're going to get an Eevee Egg, I'd rather have an Eevee on my team. So we're back into the Pokemon Center a bit. Going to our boxes, going to someone's. Goodbye. Literally, I only got you for a one sole purpose, nothing more. It's kind of annoying when we can only have six Pokemon because I really want to have like more Pokemon on my team. I know it sounds stupid because there's six for a reason, but I've really just like, I have so many good Pokemon I just want to carry with me. Oh, I do have a free space. And okay, now that's a really weird one. You have to say no. I'm used to saying yes all the time. So he gives us the Eevee Egg, and be very useful when it hatches, and Eevee will be helpful in your journey across the Zhery Region, which is true, Eevee will, because of the many evolutions that it does behold. So now we can just go in summary, what will hatch from it. We already know it's an Eevee, it will take some time, an egg obtained in the most at the hot springs. So hopefully this will hatch during, not today's one. I think if you hold this down and, you know, just walk around back and forth, it might hatch. I'm not 100% sure if I can glitch it out. I have seen people do it before, and I always think like, oh, I'm gonna hatch it. I think it's based on journey and that sort of thing. So that's the first freebie. There is a Lucky Punch, so we have to talk to a girl on a bench somewhere in town, and she will give us that item, which is right here. And this makes it, I think, so you not Quick Claw. Quick Claw always does it. A Lucky Punch will help you on your journey. When equipped to Pokemon, they get strong. Oh, okay, it makes them stronger. Okay. Yeah, Quick Claw makes you attack first. This one makes you stronger in battle. So they all have their benefits depending on which one you want to choose and put it on. So then that is done. All that's left to do is challenge gym. Yeah, there's nothing else in this city that's worth considering doing. Those were the only two things, and you had to wait till Team Steam was defeated in order to get them. So we have to head to the gym to face on Esmeralda. And as you get up and behold, we have Ash and Red already there. So we click on Ash, says thanks, thank you Mark, you helped a lot. Now go after Team Steam in Cinnabar City. Esmeralda told me that they came to the city to further their plans by getting the red and blue orbs. I'll do my best to defeat them, and I'll be waiting for you there, Mark. I'm off in search for new adventures, but I'll look out for you too, Mark. So now they go, knowing that we're on their team and they're going to meet up with us later on our journey when we get to Sinnoh Port. Which, I don't know when that will be, but, you know, it may be coming up soon. I have to keep my fighting Pokemon very strong and well trained, so I use a lot of protein to increase their power. That's very nice to know. Now, this gym is a grass gym. Yeah, the last gym we faced was a bug type gym. This time it's a grass type, which makes my Combustion another reliable source. Yes, I could use it in my new team, but if I have a Pokemon that's going to be best effective and best well equipped, I might as well do that. Now, in this gym, there are a total of 4 NPC trainers, all have 3 Pokemon each and between 22 to 23 levels, but they give you a decent amount of money as well. Well, at least 2 of them do, but you still get a decent amount to bring on with you. And so if you're struggling and you like want to pick up some new items in the shop, defeating these trainers, then you can buy those items. So Carla sends out her Cacnei, Which will actually, if I defeat this one, it will put me to 33 and I'll be 3 more away from my Blaziken. Oh my god, I so badly want my Blaziken now. Mate, this is going to be amazing. Yay, 3 more levels to go! It feels like I'm playing Pokemon Ruby again when I'm just using this Pokemon for the first time and I really want to see what it can evolve into. I think that's the best thing I love about the new games, is the Pokemon that you get to see the evolution chain. Like, yeah, Sword and Shield wasn't the greatest, but at least they had their own unique style. They brought something new, at least. Okay, they weren't top of the range, but they still had a unique evolution set. Not one of my best games I played, but still one of the most vibrant ones. I think she just had starter Pokemon. I think she just had, like, base starter Pokemon. Why? At least evolve him, at least. You could evolve that Turquoise, man. You could have evolved it. Though, speaking of Pokemon and their evolutions, do you remember Gen 2? And this was where you had, like, Cyndaquil, Chikorita, and Totodile. I always thought that they had like a pattern, so that grass types evolved earlier. Because you remember Bulbasaur from Gen 1, when that evolved at level 16, we thought, okay, 36 is going to be the next one. It evolved into Venusaur level 32. So when it came with the Gen 2, I was thinking, okay, maybe Chikorita is going to evolve at 32. No. Chikorita evolved at 16 to 36. It was Totodile, Totodile, that evolved earlier on and had a different change up pace. Because I think Totodile evolved at, I think it was 14, or it evolved early into a Flagellator at 32. And then it evolved into Croconaw at 18. I'm not 100% sure, it might have actually been 16, but I remember Flalligator was the earliest evolution. Keep in mind, water types are the easiest to level up. So having that was a good improvement, because you get to evolve it earlier on. But then after that, they kept them all as the 16 and 36, which was pretty acceptable. But back then, it was really unique seeing an early stage Pokemon evolving later than earlier in its final form. It was pretty good, and I quite like that. Added something new and a flair to it. Now it's all just the same, but grass types are always the hardest to level up because they take more XP. Water types are the more easiest, and fire types are more balanced depending on how further they go in evolution. Like, you know, if you final evolve them, they're going to take a bit more, but grass types were hard all the way around. It's just a well-known fact at that point. I don't think I'm gonna get a Kabusk in this video. I think it might actually be next video, which is quite shameful. I'm really looking forward to actually having on my team, because I really want to like spice it up. Because I have like an idea in my head of a dream set move, and it's whether or not if I can pull it off in this video. Like not in the video, but like in the actual game itself. Because I don't know what TMs and stuff is available earlier on in that. So. It's all just like waiting and like finding out if I can actually do the moves that I want. Because I remember I was playing Pokemon Revolution Online and someone had a Blaziken and they showed me it. And it was like, mate, your movesets are what I really want to happen in Gen 3. But they weren't possible due to the Gen 6 movesets. So yeah, I really hope they are in here. Because I could play them for ages. Now that is a dead end down there. So I know there isn't going to be a Pokemon trainer there, but then this is where things get interesting. Okay, we can now move the box. Okay, just move that to that side and move that down like so. Boom, see, that's how we do it. Obviously this is a dead end, but still I cleared them all. Oh, that's very proud of me, you know. Big achievement. Big achievement indeed. Your boy's got stats. All trainers who face me are bound to lose. Well, here's your lucky day, because you are now bound to lose to Wah. And it's time to do this with one Pokemon. Ooh, Aggrotto! She actually has an evolved Pokemon! May I never seen. Hey, the NPCs are moving up. They are moving. That means I'm going to get more XP. 160. Oh, mate. Come on, really? At least give me a decent 500 XP. That was poor. I literally got more from the last trainer. Oh. Normally, if you defeat a high, evolved form Pokemon, you get more XP. And now she has a Gloom. I have no idea what her preference is, but blimey. A Gloom, really? A Gloom? I don't think I've ever used a Gloom in a battle. I said that before, actually. But I didn't ever did. Bye, Mary. And now there should be one more NPC trainer after this one. Now it's the struggle of trying to get through this. Oh, man, this was very hard. Oh, I thought I would be there for ages with that one. Jesus Christ, thank God for that. Here, I'll just make it easy for myself, you know, so I don't accidentally block myself off. That'd be very terrible, you know. Oh, God. God, we. All right, now it's time for Joanne. I think that's how you say the name. Yeah, Joanne. Or Jonah. Duan or Guan? You're Joanne to me, mate. Oh, I should really stop trying to pronounce names. I'm not good at it. I've never was since I first started. Like, can you believe I've been, oh god, this channel was started in 2010. This is a 10-year-old channel. And I still can't pronounce Pokemon's names and all that correctly. And I love the games and all that. And I still suck really bad at trying to pronounce names. It's one of my most biggest weaknesses in life. It takes me a while to remember people's names. I think that's where it comes from. I can't remember stuff straight away. Like numbers and all that. Like names. I have to really know you. And, you know, remember all your names. Like when I start a new job, it takes me a few days and I'll remember your names because I see you every day. It triggers into my mind. So yeah, I was just, over the 10 years, I should know all this stuff, but I still struggle with the names. So I think now I might just attempt it, but then won't make a big deal out of it. Before, I would really hate it because it would put me off doing commentary, because I would just stutter and struggle with a certain name, and I'm thinking, how do I pronounce it? Is this the right way? Is it going to offend anyone? And now I'm like, look, I gave it my best shot. No one's perfect, okay? It's 2020. Let's just put it on the carpet and say, I tried my best. Body slammer, yes, I'm teaching my baby body slam. I know people are going to hate me for this one, but come on, look at that. Okay, yeah, it's 15 PP, but look at that, 85%. And it causes paralysis, okay? That is good. So we got this, the poison type Pokemon. Obviously for the ground types. Heal myself up. And then we got the tackle, which I'm going to get rid of the tackle. I know I spoke about PP higher ups, but this has a higher power. And it's going to cause paralysis. So, you know, it has a better advantage at this point. So goodbye and welcome, Body Slam. Grovyle. Oh my god, this is Torchic's evolution. No, not Torchic. Treecko, that was it. Treecko. I'm so bad. Oh my god. I think, of all grass starter Pokemons, Grovyle is by far the coolest. Treecko's evolution is the coolest evolution in the entire Pokemon starter series. Out of all the starter Pokemon, none gets cooler than Treecko. I think many people will agree with me on that one. It is a cool Pokemon. It just stands out dramatically. You suppressed me with the effectiveness of your technique. And I got 368 Pokédollars for that one. So as that way, well, how much money do I have real quick? Let's go to my mark. 17.2. Mate, that is good. 17,000 Pokédollars. I would take that any day of the week. Right. Now it's time to face the music. just gonna have this for the nice thumbnail, why not? Alright, Esmeralda, let's do this. Greetings, Mark. Welcome to the Esmeralda City GYM. Now, I will show you the power of grass Pokemon in battle. Whoa! Mate, I am literally prepared. She has four Pokemon, all between 25 and 27. I am ready for this. Like this, you have no idea. The second badge is mine. She has an Ivysaur. Mate, Ivysaur isn't the coolest, mate. You're just gonna lose. Bye, though. Good attempt. Yeah, I think that's what... I hated grass Pokemon for a very long time until Gen 3. When I saw Treecko, I thought it's the coolest grass type. So it's the only exception. Bulbasaur was the worst one. I hated Bulbasaur. It was just ugly and plain and boring. Same with Gen 2. Like, Chikorita was cute and adorable. But I never really got into grass types because of Gen 1. And then when Gen 3, I saw the Treecko, I was thinking, you know what? It's got something in his mouth. He stands out from the rest. He looks like he's a determined fighter, and I chose him. I loved it. So yeah, it's weird seeing Ivysaur after all this time. Like the one that made me hate grass type Pokemon, and now I love grass types because they just look so cool. But look at that! He has a tree on his back. Only in Pokemon would that be possible. And it's super effective, and I love how he had the Mew cry as well. And Bayleaf got some XP. I'm 34, two more levels away and I will have my Blaziken. Esmeralda is about to send out Jumpluff. I'm not going to change Pokemon. Even though Jumpluff you could probably say is a levitation Pokemon because they do levitate. I wouldn't really, would you class it as grass type? It's really weird for me because it doesn't look like a grass type to me. It just doesn't. It looks like a cotton. I don't know. Normal, yes. I'm going to fast forward up because I'm asleep. It was just going to take too long. I'll leave it up to you whether it's a grass up or not. Esmeralda sends out our last one, Savine. No, I do not want to change Pokemon. And look at that. That specimen is beautiful. I think that's... Oh my god. I don't want to say this wrongly. Gen 5? It might be Gen 5. I'm trying to think because Gen 4 was Diamond and Pearl. Yeah, Diamond and Pearl. And I'm trying to think what was the starter Pokemon. You know, it might be Gen 4 actually. I'm not 100% sure. So either Gen 4 or 5. But if I had to choose one... Oh my god, I'm out of PP. I use Peck. If I had to choose, I want to say Gen 5. But I didn't play Pokemon Black and White. So yeah, it is Gen 4. It has to be Gen 4 because I haven't played Pokemon Black and White. So how will I know what Gen 5 is like? Because Gen 6 was X and Y. So yeah, Gen 4. I'm saying Gen 4. I really hope I'm right. You know? Like, I could be wrong, but I'll leave that to the people in the comments section. I'm going to say Gen 4. Is that your locking answer? Yes, it is. And I really hope I'm right. So I got 540 for winning from a gym leader. It's very bad. Well, you were great in battle. After that victory, you deserve the second badge of the Zhery League, the green badge. With the green badge, you can use moves like Lava Surf to pass through difficult areas. I have no idea what the hell Lava Surf is. Is it just? Does it mean I can only like surf on lava? Like really? Oh. And this was of the Great Drain. Oh, Giga Drain. Yeah, that was it. God, you saw me stuttering again there. But yeah, Giga Drain is a lot more efficient. If you're trying to absorb health, it would take a great deal amount of it. So yeah, that's all we got done for today. We defeated Esmeralda and achieved the second badge, which is pretty good. And oh my god, I have to go through this bit again? Really? Ugh. There we go. Boom, made it look all pretty. But yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed today's video. Next time, we'll be going the Route 407 to continue our adventure. There's nothing else to do in this area, so you can feel free to do whatever you want. You can train in the wild area like I did, or just proceed forward if you're comfortable with the team you got. I do hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and like always, show support by liking the video, subscribe to my channel, and when you do subscribe, make sure to turn post notifications by clicking that bell icon to keep up to date with all the latest, and I'll see you next time. But until then, take care.